It's all or nothing in Valencia. It's lights out and we are racing. Firing away from pole position, the dream star from world champion, Pecco Bagnaia. He's going to lead the field into the first corner. The KTMs are side by side on the run down to turn one as well. Martin's had a really good start as well. He's coming through up almost in the second place.
He is going to be second as they go into turn two. He's up the inside of Brad Binder. Jorge Martin could not have scripted that much better. Bagnaia, though, has got the start he wanted. Clear tarmac ahead of him.
Can Martin pounce on the run to the first corner?
Well, that number one Ducati really does punch up that final corner, even with that ball line. Contact between the two of them.
Wow.
Martin runs off.
That's Martin. He got sucked into the dirty air, didn't he? Behind Bagnaia. And that could be it. That could be the world championship over here.
Marquez through again. On Tarco. You saw the smoke from his boots as Martin picks the opportunity up and goes through on Bagnaia. This time, that's for keeps.
This is MotoGP at its very best, when it's all on the line. The world's best riders go for it. Oh, that's Marquez and Jorge Martin. They've tangled in turn four, and that is your lot. That is game over. It's all gone wrong for Martin.
Yeah, he collects Marc Marquez,
who gets launched into orbit. That was horrendous for Marc Marquez. This is a tough one to take. This will take him a while to get over. So much sympathy as well for the luckless Marc Marquez. Nothing that Marquez could do about that one. He was just on his normal racing line going through that fourth corner.
Martin out.
And Pecco Bagnaia now can breathe a huge sigh of relief because he is retaining the MotoGP World Championship. Your heart goes out, though, to Martin and to Pramac Ducati. Brad Binder, he still leads this Grand Prix, and KTM on course for a dream ending to 2023 because they have a 1-2 right now. What's happened to Binder?
He's dropped back to sixth.
What's happened to Binder?
I was just looking there, Jack Miller's leading.
So Jack Miller, out of nowhere, had a 1.2 second leader, and Binder's obviously made a huge mistake on that lap 14, just over half race distance, completed in Valencia, and Binder's lost nearly 4 seconds. Oh, he goes, same mistake he made in the sprint, even worse though, wasn't it?
That penalty lane.
Well, he ran wide there when trying to find a way through. Well, he let Jorge Martin through in the sprint, and that is a proper dropping of the ball, isn't it, for Binder?
Jack Miller suddenly is now in position to take a victory for the first time since Motegi last year. Here comes Binder then at the inside of Alex Marquez, and he bashes Alex Marquez aside, and you can see what Alex thinks of that. That's the first and last time you do that to me, he says. Binder lined this one up through turn three, and this is into four, and he just barges his way through on Alex Marquez. Brad Binder, he's been told to drop one position. Brad Binder will see now, if he hasn't already, that he needs to draw one position. He's too busy trying to gain one from Maverick Viñales. Here's Binder then, certainly not looking like he's going to try and drop a position. He's now going to drop two.
Yeah, Binder pretty clearly hasn't seen the message.
But if he doesn't, he might get a long lap, and he's now sticking his left foot out there on the way out of turn of one. There is a lot of anger behind that helmet.
There really is.
By the way, Brad, is not the one position you need to drop.
It's not. He's got to get in as well here behind Fabio De Gianantonio too.
They're saying Brad Binder to drop one position completed. I've got to say, that's nonsense, because he gained one before he dropped it.
Yeah, how does that work? The position he had to drop was sixth place behind
De
Gianantonio. Anyway, drop position completed for Brad Binder.
Oh, the man of the field! And is that him down at the front?
Is that
Miller?
Is Miller
down.
Oh, Jack Miller's gone down hard in the gravel trap at turn 10. KTM are throwing away, well, they've thrown away a 1-2.
What more
a 1-2 that was in their hands a few laps ago. Brad Binder made a mistake going into turn 10 that saw him lose nearly 4 seconds, and he lost the lead.
Well,
and now
here
is Miller going into turn 10. What an eventful final Grand Prix this has been for Binder. And don't discount the South African, actually, out of winning this Grand Prix. He lost 3 seconds when he ran wide, didn't he, at turn 14? Although he's now desperately trying to fight away onto the podium, because De Gianantonio does sneak on the inside through turn 11.
Fabio De Gianantonio started 11th on the grid, remind you.
Here he comes into turn number four. He dispenses of Zarco, and De Gianantonio up into second place. How much does Bagnaia want to retain his world title from the top step of the podium? The last opportunity then for Fabio De Gianantonio. He's got turn 14 remaining as the curtain comes down on this incredible 2023 World Championship campaign. He comes on the inside of Bagnaia. He will not be close enough. And Pecco Bagnaia retains the MotoGP World Championship. Pecco Bagnaia is your 2023 MotoGP World Champion. And he does it in some style. He takes the victory in a Valencia Grand Prix, which was one of the best of the season. What a season for Ducati and for Pecco Bagnaia.
That is the way that you clinch the biggest prize of all on two wheels. Pecco Bagnaia, race winner, world champion.
If you love MotoGP videos, like and subscribe.